Hello, hello. What is up, Verizon Up members? I am Zuri Hall. I'm so excited to be back again for another week of this awesome virtual concert series that Verizon throws. We all need a little live music these days, so I cannot wait for Chloe and Halle to take the stage. From the looks of it, neither can you. I can see everything that you're talking about in the chat. Atakura Smith says, so thrilled to be with my fellow Baileyans. 5 minutes. The time has come. Let's get excited. We are celebrating you, the Verizon Up members, tonight. We are also honoring women artists in this amazing music industry of ours, and Chloe and Halle. It doesn't get more iconic, more talented than that. So in just a little bit, these amazing ladies are going to take the stage. We know that's what you're all here for. I can't wait. I'm counting down. But first, we're going to chat a little bit, get to know each other in the chat, and then we're going to do a 45-minute show, which you are all waiting for, and the ladies are coming to you live from the Wiltern in Los Angeles. So they're setting up on the stage right now, and then we're going to wrap things up with a Q&A. So we're going to go two-on-one, with Chloe and Halle. But before we do that, let's go ahead and check out this chat, okay? So like I said, we saw Atakura Smith. She's excited to link up with the Baileyans tonight. How y'all feeling? Let's see what's going on over here. Serenity Eubanks in the building. Serenity, the first time that she saw the girls was in Austin. Now we're getting our virtual concert on. Very exciting. A lot of first-timers in the building tonight, the virtual building. So let me ask you guys this. Do we have any favorite Chloe and Halle songs? I want to get to know everybody, see what you're excited to hear on the stage tonight. Personally, Busy Boy all day. That's my favorite. Let's see what you guys are talking about. There we go. Tasha says, I'm so excited, so excited. Oh, and just a heads up, guys. We see that if anyone is having tech issues or maybe a little bit of a sound issue right now, getting it all straightened out. So hold tight. We're going to sort it out. You're going to be good. We're going to be good. You've got some time before they take the stage. Brittany Alvarado says, oh, my Lord, look at their outfits looking freaking amazing. I agree. You know they always come. They serve on this stage, no doubt. Christian, I love them so much. Okay, Shanika Jones, she says, hi, I am super excited about the show. I'm from Alabama. Where are the rest of you guys tuning in from? I am currently in Washington, D.C., but based in L.A. A lot of first-timers. Melody Short says her favorite song is Do It. Definitely a good one. Oh, a lot of Do It. Okay, V. Renee Miranda fills me on the Busy Boy. Been there before. Shanika, hers is Do It also. Asia's on the Busy Boy tip. Got it. Von Lise? I don't know if I pronounced that right, but Lonely. Justin Merton says, I want Busy Boy plus everything else. So you just want all the songs tonight. You just want a start to finish full set. Well, you're going to get it. A 45-minute Chloe and Halle show. Oh my gosh, these outfits are everything. These ladies, oh, this is going to be amazing, y'all. I'm so excited. Just a few minutes more, and then Chloe and Halle are going to take the stage. Let's go ahead and check back in with this chat. Okay, we've got Chicago in the building, Texas, Michigan. What is so awesome about this? Oh, I see Harlem. Shout out to Harlem. I used to live there for a minute, 145th in Amsterdam. What is so awesome about these series is the fact that even when we're all apart, especially right now during the holidays, right, we can be together, and music more than anything just does that for us, you know? So I love that we get to all be here together with our favorite songs, keeping my fingers crossed for Busy Boy. Caitlin McKinney, ATL, okay. Tasha in South Carolina, Maryland. Okay, Erin, so you're like up the street from me. Yeah, I was in Baltimore earlier today, so shout out to Maryland. Chin Year says, okay, can y'all hear? We want to make sure sounds good for everyone. Okay, perfect. Hang in there. If you can't hear, you should hopefully be able to hear soon, okay? A lot of Carolinas in the building. Christian Mack says, I am here to get my wig snatched by Chloe and Halle. Same. It is ultra secure tonight, specifically for that reason, okay? We've got extra pins in the situation because wigs will be snatched tonight, no doubt, no doubt. Cavante Barnes is tuning in from Vegas. We've got Huntsville, Alabama in the building. Okay. Tulsa, Ohio. Okay, Vitaly is from Ohio. I'm from Toledo. Love it. Got the popcorn ready. Baltimore, Joanne Kelly. Okay. Serenity says music literally saved my life, and she is tuning in from Pennsylvania. That's awesome. Wow. Brittany Alvarado, where words fell, music speaks. Amen to that. And Gabriel says, Chicago, what a great way to start my holiday vacation. Exactly. It doesn't get any better than this. A live concert from Chloe and Halle coming in just a few minutes more. Oh, I think the ladies are ready to take the stage. Are you guys ready? The moment you've been waiting for? All right. Virtual drum roll, please. Coming to you live from the Wiltern in Los Angeles, the iconic, dynamic, insanely talented duo of Chloe and Halle.
Holding my breath till my face turns blue. Head underwater, breathe deeply, they say. I need a weekend again. Looking for bright sights. No one to high tides. Running so fast, I don't want my shoes. Head on the pavement, I'm just trying to win. Pushing the river, I swim. Nothing can blindside me like a high tide. So happy to be here with you all virtually. We're gonna have some fun tonight. Hey!
Y'all know this song?
I'm Chloe.
And I'm Halle.
And we gonna do it tonight. Hey! Yeah. We might face moving fast, cause the Uber on the way. Taking pictures, make sure you can't see no legs. That we secure like the money in a safe. I look like that. To the gate, got we so lazy. We
Drunk, or did you mean to send it to another girl? Hey, no. And by the way, Sing it, sis. Woo! So, everyone who is watching, hi. We just want to say hello, first of all. This is so cool, doing this virtually. We're at the Wiltern in LA, and it's so much fun. And this next song that we're about to sing is actually the title track of our sophomore album called Ungodly Hour. And this song is so special to us because it was the start of it all for us for this time, this round, the second album. So we want you all to sing along from your computer screens.
We love you all. Thanks for all the support.
Yeah.
Hey.
Walking over here, the way that it went down, that's when I knew. We've been talking all night, but I could tell you need to work on you. You, you like you, you, you like you, like you. Oh, you be playing sweet, but baby, don't you know that talk is cheap? You care for me,
what you doing?
I wish that you could back it up for me.
We were like, okay, you know when you really like somebody, but you've had your heart broken. So you're a little scared getting into it. And it's like, okay, I'm drunk on his love, but he's not gonna hurt me. Cause if he does, I'm gonna do something to him. Figuratively, but this is tipsy. You all know this one. Hey.
I've been kissed by darling, go sign me the New Orleans. I've been charged with murder, but someone to push me further. I hit you where it hurts, yeah, if you don't put me first, yeah. And I don't give no apologies, if you lose a life, that's not on me, yeah. Better, baby, better, treat me better. Better than those other guys who change up like the weather, yeah. It is such a shame that they were missing, they can't find. boy, if you ain't acting right. Key your cart and crash the lights. Hit your head, I'm not polite. Then I hunt down your family. Let them know about the tragedy. Who did it? A mystery. But you know that it was me. Yeah.
You better, babe, you better
treat me better, babe.
Better than those other guys who change up like the weather.
Yeah.
It is such a shame that they were
missing. They can't find them now.
Oh, I wonder how I accidentally put them in the ground. Yeah.
Make It Harder on Me is the next song. I think we got emotionally into that one, so I just completely blinked. But this next song is one of my favorite songs off of this album because I love the vibe of it. I love the feel, and it's also just you going back and forth with your heart. So I want you all to sing along from your home, from wherever you are. And sing it with us.
This always feels old school to me.
Just friends now. You already had your chance. So I need you to stop saying the things you say. I don't want to regret now the reason I didn't stay.
You all are with us watching virtually. I hope you all are having fun. I'm having fun. I'm sweating. I'm feeling good. But sadly, it's our last song, guys. Can you believe it? I can't believe it. But this one will always be near and dear to our heart. And this one's called Cool People. And this one's dedicated to all of you beautiful souls watching. All of you who send us positive energy from here, near, and far. And we love you and we want to thank you for supporting us. We mean it. From the bottom of our hearts, we would not be here without you all. And I can't wait for bigger and better and what's in store. And we love you. This is for you.
Retina, these
Thank you, Verizon. We love you. Hey,
we love you for amazing fans.
Woo! Bye, guys. Oh, we'll be back.
Absolute chills. That was so amazing. Chloe and Halle killing it on stage, per usual, as they do. I know y'all have been loving it too. I've been reading your comments in the chat. So many amazing comments. I think it's Chiara or Kiera Williams says, thank you, Verizon, for showcasing these amazingly talented Black women. They played an amazing show. That they absolutely did. Keep it coming, guys. How'd you like the show? How'd you like the performance? That last song, Cool People. Oh my God, absolutely speechless with that one. The harmony was next level, y'all. I wish I could. I wouldn't even try to touch that falsetto. They are so talented. Oh my God, the emojis, the comments, it's coming in. I can't keep up, y'all. Kayla Johnson says this was everything. Shane is begging for one more. Well, the good news is we have a question and answer session coming up. So you're going to get the ladies back in just a few minutes. But while they take a minute to just take a break, maybe sip some water, we are going to download you on all things Chloe and Halle. For those of you who don't know, we have to pull out the notes for this one because their bio is so impressive. As you probably know, they first rose to fame on YouTube. They were only 11 and 13 years old when they were making these amazing covers, and their video covering Pretty Hurts by Beyonce actually went viral. I think it has 19 million views now, which is absolutely amazing. Obviously, they caught the attention of Queen Bee, and the rest is history. They were featured on her visual album, Lemonade, wow, alongside Serena Williams, alongside Zendaya, and so many more amazing Black women. And then just less than a week later, they released their own five-song debut. That was called Sugar Symphony. And I'm going to keep it going, but I'm just so excited by all of these comments. You guys are super hype about that performance. Benny said they cried. Ugh, it doesn't surprise me, though. The costumes were fire, Ashley. Yes, I agree. Pierre Moore says they cold, hot, fire, all of it. All of the things. That's what Chloe and Halle were serving tonight, okay? Alexandria says, I stand. Brittany Alvarado, I feel so honored to be a part of this awesome show tonight. I'm so glad you guys are enjoying it. Shout out to all of you, our Verizon Up members. Thank you again to Verizon for hosting this amazing virtual concert. This is what we need right now, especially with everything we're going through this year. Live music makes everything better. Let's get back to the bio, shall we? Drop some of these credentials on y'all real quick, okay? They released their debut album back in March of 2018, and that earned them two Grammy nominations, one for Best Urban Contemporary Album and another for Best New Artist. And on top of that, just a month ago, they received the Grammy nominations for Wonder What She Thinks of Me and also for Ungodly Hour, and their lead single from that album, Do It, we all know it, we love it, hit the Billboard Hot 100 chart. So these ladies are obviously killing it. The list doesn't stop there either. The duo starred in the hit show Grown-ish. Remember that? Love that. Love Yara Shahidi. Still on. Shout out to Freeform. They opened for Michelle Obama at the 2016 South by Southwest Music and Film Festival. And just this month, Beyonce presented them with the Rising Star Award for the Billboard Women in Music Awards. How amazing is that? And these young women are just, the future is so bright for them. They have done more in their short amount of time than many people. It's very impressive. So let's go back to the chat. Jamisha McGee says, Black excellence at its finest. Absolutely. Ania just got one long yes. Just all the S's. All the S's. Benny says, loved it. Thank you, Verizon. Oh, Cheyenne Johnson. This is really sweet. The girls, they are the air I breathe tonight. I got off work not too long ago, and I really needed this. Thank you so much, Verizon, and Chloe and Halle, for being the air I breathe. Wow. Oh my gosh, you guys, I'm loving that y'all are loving it. Pierre Moore says it was a drip on the fits for me. So Pierre is still processing the stunning looks that were served tonight on the stage. Andy says, this was a gift for my best friend and she loved it. You were an amazing best friend. Bravo, way to keep it real, hold her down. Tiffany, for real, straight magic. Serenity just needs the boots. She wants details on the boots. So maybe we can get those from Chloe. We'll have to ask. A lot of heart eye emojis. Keep it coming, guys. Let us know. What was your favorite song? Drop it in the chat. Of all the things the ladies performed tonight, which song was your favorite? Okay. Y'all keep it coming in the chat. I'll keep reading. In the meantime, I think we're ready to go for the Q&A. We are all set. Chloe, Halle, can you hear me?
Yes, Hal. Halle?
There we go.
Halle? Halle?
Halle, maybe. Halle, maybe.
Hi.
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 Are we ready to kick off the question and answer session? We've got some very big fans here who are excited.
Yes. Yay. I love your red lip. It's pretty.
Thank you, love. Everybody is loving these fits y'all have, and they also mm-hmm. want the boot details. I'm going to just assume it's custom. We can't get it.
It is custom style by Zarina Akers. She brought the vision to life, and this amazing, wow. incredible woman did all the beautiful latex, and it's like tie-dye. Mm. And I don't know if you can see, but I'm dripping like some of the black dye, but I feel like a rock star tonight because of it.
Oh, my gosh. You are a rock star. Both of you are a rock star. Thank you. No doubt. I want to kick off the Q&A with a question that is kind of like obvious about the times we're in, right? We're doing these virtual concert series. You two even joked. It kind of felt weird to like end the show and it's like, and there's no audience. What is it like for you in this day and age to be doing virtual concerts like this? And how do you keep the energy going when it's really you and your band and that's it in the room?
Yeah, it's definitely such a change, you know, doing concerts mm-hmm. without an audience. I mean, normally that's where we get the energy from and the buzzing feeling of excitement. So it's really been really interesting and cool to be able to do performances from home and also learn how to connect with people that are not right in front of you. So it's beautiful how music can really transcend and travel through so many places no matter how far you are. And I think it's just beautiful that we can all connect in this way, even though we are so far and all trying to be safe. I think we both feel really blessed and honored that we still get to do what we love, mm-hmm. even in the midst of all of this going on right now.
Yeah, absolutely. So well said. Obviously, you two are, I don't even want to say prime because I feel like the best is yet to come. Like this, it's only up from here and you've already accomplished so much. And a lot of that is attributed to your early influences, right? Who shaped you musically when you were younger. You guys have, you know, taken off at such an early age. I was mentioning the fact 11 and 13 years old on YouTube with those amazing covers. Who inspired you two when you were younger and sort of finding your voices as artists? Were there specific singers? I mean, I'm just going to assume Queen Bee is on the list, but I'll let you take it.
Yeah, well, first, for the first part of it, you know, I feel like my sister and I, we just love music. We're huge music lovers and fans, and I'm so flattered that you think we're in our prime, but I feel we have still such a very, very long way to go, and we're just beginning, mm-hmm. and we've been inspired by so many of the greats. Of course, Beyonce, like you mentioned, and Nina Simone, and currently, I have been obsessed with Imogen Heap and Grimes and Meryl Garbus of Toon Yards, as well as Missy Elliott, all the incredible women producers who just make incredible work. So also Khalees. I can't forget Khalees. I love her and Donna Summer. So I've been inspired by a lot recently. And my sister has like amazing music, too, that she's always putting me on.
Oh, okay, yeah. You gonna give us a few, Halle?
Yeah, I feel like Chloe and I have similar, you know, inspirations. I feel like she listed mine. The only one I would add would be Billie Holiday, Nat King Cole, and then all the rest that she listed are just such amazing, powerful women that we're just like, wow, about.
mm-hmm. Okay. And you mentioned the fact, Halle, that, you know, like I said, also, I completely agree. Prime isn't even the word because you're nowhere near it yet. And that says a lot because look at where you are right now. The fact that you are Grammy nominated and at such a young age, walk us through what that was like, that first reaction to your first ever Grammy nomination. What was that experience like for you after so much hard work being put in?
Oh, my gosh. Well, When it comes to Grammy nominations, we were always super shocked, super surprised, especially with our first album, because that was just something that we put out into the world, all of our love that we put out into the world. We never expected anything to come from it. And so for that to happen, it was like, whoa. So for this second album, Ungodly Hour, it was kind of the same thinking. We didn't expect much when we released it. We're just like, you know what? These are songs from our heart that inspire us, that were our therapy sessions, that were our diary entries, that we're just going to give to the world. So maybe even if a few people like it or connect to it, then we feel like we've done something. We've done our part. You know, that's what we love about music, is that we can just say what's on our heart and just release it into the world, and maybe somebody will take something from it, and it'll heal somebody in some way. So whenever we get recognized, I mean, again, this year we were like screaming, like, what the heck is going on? Like, how did we get so lucky? You know, we just feel really blessed, but we do also work really, really hard. So at the same time, we're like, you know what? I'm really proud of us because we have worked really hard to get here. We just feel very honored every time we think about it.
Yeah. What is your favorite song on Ungodly Hour and why for each of you?
Oh, wow. Well, tonight, I don't know. I'm just so happy we were able to perform the songs. The ones that specifically stood out to me tonight were Baby Girl and Forgive Me, because, you know, you go through a lot of obstacles in your life and you learn and you grow. And even though it might be painful sometimes, you learn to do what's best for you. And I feel like that's exactly what Baby Girl is about growing and being okay with that and being okay to fall and make mistakes and just going along with the flow and just knowing it'll be okay. And Forgive Me, I love, because it's about taking your power back, not letting yourself get walked all over. And I really love Forgive Me for that exact reason. And it's so funny how these songs we wrote last year are so relevant to us right now, currently.
Wow. Halle, what would you add?
Oh my gosh. The question was the songs, right?
Yeah.
Which songs you love the most on this album? I don't know. I just love all the songs. But today,
that is an answer. That is an acceptable answer. They're all good, start to finish. There's no wrong answer here. I'm going to go a little bit rogue. We have some questions in the chat. And
who is this?
Someone was asking, will you two queens ever return to acting again? Is there more acting in the future for you?
Chloe?
Allie?
Yes.
I mean, I know Halle's got a big moment coming, right? I was on the red carpet talking about the Little Mermaid. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah. So there's that. And there's more for Chloe. So I think, yeah, it's something that we like to dabble in. So, I think so.
Okay. And obviously, we're doing this all virtually because this has been quite the year. I'm curious to know, what are you two doing when you're not in the zone for music to kind of keep busy? Have you learned any new talents? Anybody in the kitchen learned how to cook? Are you, you know, arts and crafts things? What are you doing when you're not in the studio this year?
I mean, for me, I feel like all we really do is music. And if we're not doing music, like, we're sleeping.
This is life.
Yeah. Halle likes to bake. And we're going to bake some Christmas cookies on Christmas Eve. Vegan Christmas cookies, which I'm very excited about because they're so good every year. And at the beginning of the pandemic, because I really love Legos, I was building a lot. But I haven't done that recently, honestly.
Because we've been too busy.
Yeah, we've been too busy. But we're really grateful. I'm happy that music is really all we do. And yeah, I can't wait for more.
No, that's a great thing. Music being all you do and that being what you love. I can't think of a better thing to be able to do for a living. That's such a blessing. If there was any performer that you could perform with on stage from past or present, it doesn't have to be technically possible. Who would you love to take or have taken the stage with?
Can I just say, you are so pretty. First of all.
Oh my gosh. Thank you, Halle. Same to both of you. You are so sweet.
But oh my gosh, a performer, that'd be hard.
Yeah.
I mean, Prince, Billie Holiday.
Yes. Oh,
I mean, I would be too scared to go on stage with them at all. I would be like,
I think for me, Prince, Donna Summers, I just think the way that she owns her sexuality on stage is just so sexy and strong and empowering. Mm. So definitely her. Alive, Andre 3000. I think he's the coolest guy ever. So that would be really cool.
Yes.
Of course, Beyonce yes. one day. That would be really fun for us to do. There's so many. Even Rosalia, current artist, like her voice is insane and even her production. So that would be cool one day. There's just possibilities are endless. So I hope some of those come true.
Yeah, oh, I'm sure they will. I have no doubt. I've got a few more questions here. And just so you guys know, these were submitted by Verizon Up members who are curious about the answers. But one that I just saw pop up in the chat, they're asking, oh my gosh, these questions are coming in so fast, I can't keep up with it, to be honest. Oh. Okay, I'm not going to ask this question about Beyonce, even though it's iconic and I really want to know the answer. Okay, Janae says, Sirens want to know if y'all are going to Brazil. Where do you guys want to go? Once the travel, you know, restrictions are lifted and everything's safe, where would you love to be touring and visiting?
Oh, definitely Brazil. We've never been, but that would be incredible. Honestly, I'm like, I can't wait for touring. I hope we can when all of this craziness ends. Like, I just miss feeling the incredible energy from the audience, but I feel it virtually from you guys. So thank you so much for tuning in and hanging with us. And definitely Brazil, a bunch of different places. Mm-hmm. Honestly, any place with warm water for me so I could go run into the beach and jump in the waves.
It's warm. Listen. Yeah. Shivering right now, as long as it's warm.
Y'all cold?
Yeah.
It's a little chilly in LA. Okay, when it comes to new music, what are the plans? What can you tell us? We're still savoring Ungodly Hour, but if you could give us a little something about what to expect next.
Yes, well, right now for us, new music is really, it's at the beginning right now of us just creating songs, starting from the top, writing what's on our heart. And, you know, the formation of putting together an album kind of comes after you kind of have these natural thoughts, these natural demos that we would say. So we can't wait for when we start putting it together again. But right now we're just kind of free form writing and doing what's inspiring to us. And hopefully it will be a complete thought, you know, and maybe a few months it'd be fun to explore what a new album would sound like. But of course, right now on Godly Hour, we're savoring singing these songs live. You know, it's just a really exciting thing because these events like this, it's like, wow, we actually get to perform the songs from our album, which we haven't gotten a chance to do for people. So with you guys, it's amazing to do it with you. So thank you for listening. So yeah, I'd say that's kind of what to expect for us.
Okay, got it. We'll take it. And okay, I'm gonna just ask this. I'm gonna throw it out here. Vicky Lake says, I just need to know what Beyonce smells like. Why do y'all hate me? So
I think you'll have to find out yourself.
They said you're going to have to find out yourself, Vicky, okay? So you're going to have to do some digging, some searching on that one. Okay, we've got, Christian says, who writes the songs? What's the process like for your creation? Is it mostly you two? Do you try to collaborate with various writers?
Yeah, so my sister and I, since the beginning of time, really, when we started creating music, it has been so important to us to own our music and to just have complete and full control. And, you know, that started with the songwriting and then into the production with me. I really love producing, and just Halle and I creating in our home studios first at our first home in LA, it was our living room. And now we converted the garage into our studio at this home. So it's always fun creating. You know, we never have a formula when it comes to creating. Sometimes Halle will come up with beautiful chords on her guitar. Sometimes I'll have a lyric written down in my notes, or I'll come up with a beat idea that we really like, or one of us hears a melody. And, you know, I just love how both my sister and I bring something different to the table when we create, and that's what creates Chloe and Halle, because you have both of what we love and our influences and everything in. Mm-hmm. We don't try to compromise, really. We just kind of make it work and make it fit in like a puzzle piece. We turn it around until it fits, you know, because I think we both have something really special to offer, and it's not fair to the other to dim it, so we just make it work musically.
I love that. Because you are so invested and hands-on in your creative process, what's the end goal with any album, with any song? What are you hoping that the listeners take away when they experience, because that really is what it is, it's like a full immersion, when they experience your music?
Yes, wow. I feel like we really just hope listeners take away some piece of love, something that they relate to. Sometimes it's really therapeutic for me, especially when I listen to people's music, just hearing a situation that I'm going through that I can belt at the top of my lungs. And then once I finish belting it out in the car, then I feel better. And I just want people to feel better, you know, after listening to our music and maybe heal or feel some sort of healing in any sort of way. So we just want all the good vibes people to feel when they hear our music.
I feel like the possibilities are endless. Like my sister and I, we love even writing for movies and, you know, looking at a scene and something and like creating it for that. We love to do that. And even with our other projects as well, writing for other artists, I would love to produce for other artists too and begin scoring and filling all that in with all these different cool films and TV shows and stuff. So musically, the possibilities are endless for us. And we just going to keep growing, keep working hard, and seeing where it takes us.
I love it. I love it. Really quickly, Tiffany Mack says, how many instruments do you play?
Uno.
There are a lot.
Uno.
What?
Uno.
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 Yeah, Uno. One. I play guitar.
We used to, like in school, Halle played the cello and I played the violin. Okay. But we don't play it anymore. I changed my elective from orchestra to choir. So, but I've been saying for years I want to learn how to play the drums because I do the beat machine, but I feel like I'm just not really giving it all if I'm not playing the actual drums. So, speaking of instruments, we had like an incredible band with us, like all female. They're amazing. Mm. And our incredible music director helped put it all together because we were overseas and his name's Derek Dixie and it was his birthday today. Happy birthday, Derek. Happy birthday. But yeah.
Happy birthday, Derek.
Yeah. We just love being around such incredible musical people. And I'm happy that we were able to be surrounded by that tonight and perform.
I love it. I love to hear that it was an all-female band, especially as we're celebrating women in this music industry. Just to close it out, I just want to open up the floor to you. Obviously, your fans are here, and they are so excited. If you would just say anything to them, happy holidays, whatever you want to say. The floor is yours.
Yes, we just want to say happy holidays, Merry Christmas to our beautiful supporters. Thank you for being here with us. Thank you for listening. Thank you for sending us so much love and just being an open ear. We really appreciate you guys so much. Without you, none of this is possible. So we thank you, thank you, thank you.
What Halle said, we love you guys.
Chloe, Halle, thank you so much. That was an amazing performance. And y'all stay safe.
Thank you.
Bye. Good to see you.
Bye.
Bye.